وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم امام احمد بن حنبل رحمت اللہ علیہ narrated a hadith from Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ. He says that we were sitting with the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم فجاء اعرابی الى النبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. Bidwan means a simple man, a common layman from desert. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, ji'tu ilayka ya rasulullah li as'alaka amma yughnini fi ad-dunya wal akhirah. I am here to ask you about something which can benefit me in this world and also in the hereafter. Rasulullah said, Sal ma badalak, go ahead and ask whatever you want to ask me. So he posed a few questions, and these questions are almost 24 or 25 in number. If we will look into that hadith, says Imam Mustaghfiri said that such a jami' and comprehensive hadith which can make your life in this world a content and satisfied one and in the hereafter a prosperous one. So he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Uridu an akuna a'lam an-nas. I want to be one of the learned people. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, ittaqillah takun a'lam an-nas. Fulfill your obligations to Allah. Perform your duties as a Muslim as you are bound to. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Promote virtues and prevent vices. These are different definitions or interpretation of taqwa. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, adopt taqwa. You are the utmost knowledgeable person. To the level of the taqwa you have. So then he said, uridu an akuna aghna an-nas. I want to be the richest one. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, kun qani'an takun aghna an-nas. Be content with what you have. You are the richest person in the world. As in a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that rich is not with gold and silver. ليس الغنى بالذهب والفضة ولكن الغنى غنى القلب. The actually rich are richness is here in yourself, in your heart. There will be a person, he will be having a few billion dollars, but still he will be that much haris and he will be that much greedy that you will be thinking of him that he does not have anything. While there will be another guy having $10, he will be treating you like a king that he is holding the whole world because he is rich by heart. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, kun qani'an takun aghna an-nas. So the third question, he said, uridu aw uhibbu an akuna a'dala an-nas. I want to be the just ever person. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He told him, أحب للناس ما تحب لنفسك تكون أعدل الناس. Like for others, what good you are liking for yourself, that is the justice and that is the adal, and you will be the just ever person. So then he asked a four question, and he said, أحب أن أكون خير الناس. I want to be a best person. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, kun nafi'an linnas takun khairan nas. Be a benefit for others, useful for others, providing khair to others, so you will be the best ever person. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he answered this question, so the guy, he proceeded further, and he said, أحب أن أكون أخص الناس إلى الله. I want to be a special one in the eyes of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, أكثر ذكر الله تكون أخص الناس إليه. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be mindful of Allah wherever you are. You are at home, be mindful of Allah. You are in your job or business, be mindful of Allah. You are walking on a street or road, be mindful of Allah. You are anywhere day and night. So think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is watching me. You will be a special person in the eyes of Allah. So now the Bidwan, he asked another question. أحبّ أن يكمل إيماني. I want my iman to be a perfect one. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, حسن خلقك يكمل إيمانك. حسن خلقك يكمل إيمانك. Make your character a noble one. It means that your iman is a perfect one. Because iman, the first ever thing is making your character. So if your character is noble, it means that you have the perfection or completion of your iman. So then he asked another question. So what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying and telling him, that is not something amazing, because he was the messenger of Allah. But amazing is the knowledge of that Bidwan, that what he is asking. And as Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, that husn al-sual nisful ilm, a best type of question is 50% knowledge. So if somebody is questioning in a proper way, you can pick there from that the guy is knowledgeable. And if somebody is making a foolish question, so you will be saying that, let me get rid of him, because he doesn't know anything. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, وَحُسْنُ الْإِقْتِصَادِ نِصْفُ الْمَعِيشَةِ. If you will discipline, you will organize your income and expenditure. So he said that 50% to your economy is good, and that is established. And Abu Bakr said in his khutbah that وَحُسْنُ التَّوَدُّدِ إِلَى النَّاسِ نِصْفُ الْعَقْلِ. That if you are practicing such a deeds that people are falling in love with you, so it means that you have 50% aqal, and for the remaining 50% you must try to have it. So the Bidwan, he had all these qualities. So he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. I want to be a good doer in the eyes of Allah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, أُعْبُدِ اللَّهِ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. Worship Allah as you are seeing Him. If not to that extent, so at least you must have such a strong belief that Allah is watching me and He sees me, so you will become for sure a good doer. Then he asked another question, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُتِعِينَ. I want to be one of the obedient people. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him that أَدِّ الْفَرَائِزِ تَكُنْ مِنَ الْمُتِعِينَ. what are mandatory for you in deen. Perform your duty properly in mandatory practices, so you would be considered one of the muti'een and the obedient people. So he said, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَلْقَ اللَّهَ النَّقِيَّ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. He said, I want to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a way that I have been cleaned of my sins, neat and clean. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, اغتسل من الجنابة متطهرا تلقى الله نقيا من الذنوب. Whenever you will do your marital job, and so right at the moment, just go and take shower. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will purify you from your zunub as well, because your nature is pure. So if your nature is pure, so you will be getting further more maturity in your ruhani and spiritual practices as well. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أُحْشَرَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي النُّورِ. I want to have my second life after death, and I have a light with me. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, لَا تَظْلِمْ أَحَدًا تُحْشَرُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي النُّورِ. Never do any injustice to any creature of Allah. You will be having light on that day. Because in a hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الظلم الظلماتٌ يوم القيامة. Zulm and wrongdoing or oppression to the creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will cause you lot of darknesses on the day of judgment, that you will be of no way, you will not be able to find a way out. So never do any wrong to any creature, so you will be there in light. He said, Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَنْ يَرْحَمَنِي رَبِّي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. I want my Lord to have His mercy on me on the day of judgment. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, إِرْحَمْ نَفْسَكْ وَرْحَمْ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ يَرْحَمُكَ رَبُّكَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Have mercy on your own self. Never do any wrong, because that is your injustice to your own self. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها وما ربك بظلام للعبيد. Whosoever is doing right good deed, so that is for his own benefit. And who is doing otherwise, he is doing injustice to his own self, because it will befall him. And your Lord, وما ربك بظلام للعبيد, he is not going to do any just injustice to anybody. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, that have mercy on your own self, and have mercy on the slaves of Allah. يَرْحَمُكَ رَبُّكَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. For sure, on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, your Lord will have His mercy on you. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الرَّحِمُونَ يَرْحَمُهُمُ الرَّحْمَانِ. Kind people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing mercy to them. اِرْحَمْ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمُكَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Have mercy on those who are on earth. So the one who is there in the heaven, he will be having his mercy on you. So then, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أُحِبُّ أَن تَقِلَّ ذُنُوبِ. I want to lessen, to make less ذُنُوبِ. If I have committed sin, I want to lessen it. Yes, to bring it down, the number. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, أَكْسِرِ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. Sitting and standing, say Astaghfirullah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will lessen your zunub. He will forgive it. He will wipe it out from your personal file. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَكْرَمَ النَّاسِ. I want to be a respected person, that the people should give me respect. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him that, لا تشك في أمرك إلى الخلق شيئا تكون أكرم الناس. Difficulties, that is the fluctuation of life. One day you will be okay, another day you will be in difficult time. But he says, don't make complaint to people. لا تشكو إلى الناس. Don't make complaint. Oh, it happened to me, like that happened to me. So he said that don't make complaint. People will give you respect. If you are complaining, everybody will try to run away of you. That this guy, we have our own worries and he is bringing his own full bag. Yes, and he is dropping it in front of us. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said that face your difficulties on your own. Never make complaints to others. So then he said, "Uhibbu an akuna aqwa an-nas." I want to be a strong man. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, "Tawakkal ala Allah, takun aqwa an-nas." Strengthen your belief in Allah, your trust in Allah, so you will be the strong man. If you don't have a tawakkul in Allah, you will be the weakest guy. You will be shaking and shivering every time. So then he said, that Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَن يُوَسِّعَ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ فِي الرِّزْقِ. I want my rizq and provision to be a spacious one. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, دُمْ عَلَى الطَّهَارَ يُوَسِّعُ اللَّهُ فِي رِزْقِكَ. That be pure every time. Yes, whenever you break your wudu, so try to make it again. Be pure every time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your rizq and your provision a spacious one. So then he said, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنْ أَحْبَابِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. I want to be a beloved of Allah and a beloved of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him very easy. أَحِبَّ مَا يُحِبُّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ تَكُونُ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِمَا. That like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes and what Rasulullah likes, so for sure you will become their beloved and they will be in love with you. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَن تُسْتَجَبْ دَعْوَتِي. That I want my dua to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, اجتنب الحرام تُسْتَجَبْ دَعْوَتُكَ. Never do haram and never put haram in your stomach. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. He said, Ya Rasulullah, أُحِبُّ أَن يَسْتُرَنِ رَبِّي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. I will be having shortcomings, but I want to be covered on the day of judgment in front of the general public by Allah. So my shortcomings and my sins and mistakes are not known to people. I want a cover. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, أُسْتُرْ عُيُوبَ إِخْوَانِكَ يَسْتُرُكَ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Cover people when you know any shortcoming of them. Don't disclose it. So if you are not disclosing the shortcomings of others to people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not discover yours on the day of judgment. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, مَنْ لَذِي يُنْجِي مِنَ الزُّنُوبَ وَمِنَ الْخَطَايَا. What is that thing which can rescue you from your sins and from your mistakes? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, الدموع والخضوع والأمراض. Humbleness. What? Humbleness. Number two. Yes, tears with the fear of Allah or from the fear of Allah. والأمراض and physical diseases if you are facing it. So that will purify you from your zunub. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أَيُّ حَسَنَةٍ أَعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. What type of good deed is the greatest one in the eyes of Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, حُسْنُ الْخُلْقِ وَالتَّوَاضُ وَالصَّبْرُ عَلَى الْبَلَاءِ. Number one, noble character. Number two, humbleness. And number three, patience when you are facing difficulties. So that is a great good deed in the eyes of Allah. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, أَيُّ سَيِّئَةٍ أَعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. That what type of deed is the worst one or the hated one in the eyes of Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, سُوءُ الْخُلْقُ وَالشُّحُّ الْمَنَّاعُ. That bad character, وَالشُّحُّ الْمَنَّاعُ, and that bukhul or miserliness, that I should not say after dars, I will tell you a good ta'bir in this regard. Yes, that will be a good ta'bir. That you are not spending anything, you are too cheap in your life. So that is the worst ever thing in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Mallazi yuskinu ghadab al-rab. Mallazi yuskinu ghadab al-rab. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has become angry, what can calm down his anger? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, As-sadaqatu al-khafiyya wa silatu al-rahim. To show kindness to your relatives. And number two, to help someone in such a way that help of your is not known to anybody. You help someone, you gave him something, you gave him some help, but only for the sake of Allah, not for name and fame. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mal ladhi yutfi'u nara jahannam. The hellfire, that is a blazing fire. What can extinguish the fire of hell? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, As-sabr fi dunya ala al-masaib wal-bala. Patience on difficulties in the worldly life, that will cool down the fire of Jahannam. So then he said, Uhibbu an akuna aminam min sakhatillah. I want to be on the safe side from the anger of Allah. So what should I do? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, La taghzab ala ahadim min khalqillah. Never show your anger to a weak one from the creature of Allah. Yes, so you will be safe from the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam al-Mustaghfiri said that this hadith, when I read it, so I tried to my best to bring it to my own practice, because and in the same way, my life has become very easy and I am living a satisfied life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow these commandments of Rasulullah, advices of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to make our life a good one here and also in the hereafter. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khairi khalqi Muhammadin wa alihi.